Now, the other big story we're following tonight, a transgender inmate now suing the state, alleging she was placed in an illegal chokehold by an officer at central booking.
Yeah, the inmate alleges a brutal attack here, a brutal assault, and the officer, she says, called her slurs and then tried to cover the whole thing up.
It's an incident that happened back in 2019, but that video is only coming to light right now. WJZ investigator Mike Helgren live at central booking for us tonight with that disturbing video. Mike.
Rick, Nicole, this inmate says she continues to face retaliation and discrimination. She's been moved to a facility out in Western Maryland, and she says she filed this civil lawsuit to help other transgender inmates. The video shows a correctional officer placing inmate Amber Cantor in an apparent chokehold inside central booking, the state-run jail in Baltimore, back in June of 2019, while two other officers are in the same room. Cantor is led into a common area while two officers are holding her. She says she went unconscious, and you can see her being dropped on the concrete floor on her face. The officers then drag her limp body. Her lawsuit claims they waited to get her medical treatment, and her injuries were so severe she was later placed in intensive care at Johns Hopkins Hospital. Malcolm Ruff with Billy Murphy's law firm represents her.
I think the video is essential for the public to see what is happening behind the doors of the jail.
These are before and after pictures showing Cantor's injuries.
A broken eye socket, broken face bones, broken sinus bones. Nobody deserves to be treated like that. She was treated like an animal.
Ruff says his client was a thorn in the side of officers and jail administrators for persistently advocating for transgender inmates' rights. And what led to this video was her own protest of her treatment, that she sat on the floor demanding a supervisor. She also claims officers falsified their use of force reports.
The department should take ownership of the culture that they created that would even allow a correctional officer to address an inmate in this way.
The Department of Public Safety told WJZ they cannot comment and cited the pending litigation as the reason. WJZ asked Governor Hogan about the incident.
I haven't heard anything about that.
The officer seen placing her in that apparent chokehold at central booking has been fired by the state, according to Cantor's lawyer. He faces a felony assault and misconduct in office charges.
This is a watershed moment for transgender inmates in the state of Maryland.
Now, the other two officers face misconduct in office charges, and all these cases are moving slowly through the court system. The next hearings are scheduled in March. Reporting live at Central Booking, Mike Helgren, WJZ.